Okay, next up, we've got Helen Jane Hearn from HJ Entertains on Twitter. And she writes at hjentertains.com and at helenjane.com. Come on up, Helen Jane.
All right. Although I am sure that all of you are totally satisfied with your lives and you're totally happy with the way things are, some of you might want to be a little foxier, wealthier, happier. I can help you with that. We're going to need some ideas. And the way we get a good idea is we have lots of ideas. So I'm going to break this into two parts. One is setting the stage to have a good idea in the environment. One is just some techniques to generate a lot of good ideas. Well, a lot of okay ideas. First, we're going to need to eat. We need to feed our brains. We need to feed our brains salmon, blueberries, dark chocolate. This all helps us come up with good ideas. Other things when it comes to environment is don't come up with ideas after lunch. Nobody comes up with good ideas after lunch. We need quiet. We need focus. We need our favorite pens. We need lots of paper. More than that, we need to have our brains in a space where we believe that we can come up with good ideas. I heard a couple times today, I'm not really a good idea person. Boo. You are a good idea person. You need to put judgment, jealousy, all of those things that say, I'm really not the kind of idea person, put those away. You can come up with a good idea. Judgment and jealousy have no place here. Better than that, we have this hack in our brains. When you ask your brain a question, it answers it. So when you ask, why do I have such crappy ideas? Your brain's gonna come up with an answer. Ask yourself, why do I come up with such awesome ideas? Your brain will also answer that same way. So let's ask ourselves some questions and define what our problem is. What's the issue here? What specifically? You want to be foxier, wealthier, happier? Let's get there. But specifically, what is it about it you think that you could fix? Let's come up with the first five ideas. The great thing about the first five ideas, everybody has the same first five ideas, right? You're going to throw them out. So who cares? Come up with them. Write them down. No one else is going to see this piece of paper. Toss them. Five ideas, first five everyone has. Now we have the magic of search engines. You can come up with anything. You can find all the information in the whole world on a search engine. Set a timer, 30 minutes. Research your problem. Find out what it is specifically you did. Come up with 10 more ideas. Let's do analogies. There are similarities in other environments that have to do with your problem. So let's pretend it's resources. You have a problem with resources. How is nature solving that? How's a bakery solving that? How does a salon solve that? Let's look at those things. Now, we know people. We know people from everywhere. We have moms and brothers and boyfriends. How would they solve these problems? Look at what the character would be. Come up with more ideas. How would celebrities solve those problems? I know how Beyonce would solve a few problems. We have problems on continuums. Let's come up with five more ideas, right? We've got little to big, Roy to G-Biv. We've got ass to ankles, there are a lot of continuums. You can come up with five more ideas, all the way down. Now steal. Somebody somewhere has come up with an idea to solve your problem already. Take it. No one else is going to see this piece of paper. This is just you and your ideas. Steal, 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 steal. It's a great way to come up with something so you're not reinventing the wheel. Let's pretend you have limitless resources. I'm not just talking money. I'm also talking time, skills. Let's pretend you have all the resources in the world. Come up with five more ideas. Just add them to the list. Let's keep going. We're going to generate a lot. My favorite, terrible ideas. Come up with 10 of the worst cabbage soup, diet, bank robbing ideas you can possibly come up with. Write down 10. Terrible ideas have a place in here. No one's judging you. It's just you and your piece of paper. Now sit on it. We have these amazing subconsciouses all well-fed with salmon and blueberries. They're going to work this through. They're going to work on this problem for you. Water's good for this. Take lots of showers and baths during this time. 24 hours. Come back to it. You're going to have 10 more ideas when you're done. And hey, now you have 50 ideas. 50 okay ideas. They're not that great, but you're a star. You came up with 50 ideas. Come on. I don't know anybody else that did that today, right? So now what we do is we evaluate ideas. We look at all 50 of them and we connect. We don't go at these with axes. We're connecting. We're taking this idea and we're putting them together and we're going to make this amazing amalgamation of ideas that we've never seen before. Put them together. Don't cut them apart. So Let's celebrate. If you still don't feel like you had a good one, let's redefine the problem, go through the process again. I promise you're going to have a good idea to solve your problem. Get yourself something nice to drink. Relax. You came up with 50 ideas today, and one of them is going to be awesome. I'm Helen Jane. I write at HelenJane.com and HJ Entertains, and I can't wait to see what you come up with. Thank you.